Today, I'm taking you to meet a Slovenian tradition, the potica.
I wanted to see if industrial potica tastes the same than homemade potica. I bought first industrial potica at Petak, a famous bakery brand.
And it's industrial?
Yeah, we have a big farm and the bakery is... It's not so typical industrial because we're really watching not to have a lot of yeast. But it's the most natural it could be here in Slovenia. From our region, from us, Slovenian flour, Slovenian eggs, everything is Slovenian.
Let's see the ingredients. Even though most ingredients are natural and maybe from Slovenia, we also can find palm oil and E471. E471 is mainly used as a texturing agent. It makes the product more attractive for consumers. No studies really shows the toxicity of this additive at regulated doses. However, its excess can cause undesirable effect on the stomach and more serious consequences such as diabetes, say the EFSA, European Food Safety Authority. And the palm oil is now known for its large-scale deforestation. Then we asked the locals where is the best potica in Ljubljana. Most of them answered at my mother's house, but some people recommended the store Le Potica.
Le Potica. In Slovenian, Le Potica means beautiful woman, and potica is this cake, and le from French, it means beautiful lady.
It's co-meaning word.
Is it long to do?
It's quite procedure, half a day long.
And my mom, every year she said, again, I didn't make potica as it should be. And I thought, no, it's so good. No, it's not.
It's so plain, yeah. It's so small, yeah, it's so no good. So there's like, never leftovers, don't worry.
Yeah, these ladies who make potica at home, they are very strict to themselves. Yeah. Our generation was not so much for kitchen, but now with all these TV shows, cooking and baking is popular again.
Yeah, it goes from mother to daughter, but now mom makes it and then I will make it.
And here are the ingredients we find on their website. Although we don't know the quality and origin of ingredients, they advise us to eat it quickly. It's a guarantee of freshness. Now that we have two types of potica, it's time to meet Irena Kršina, a Slovenian grandmother who will cook for us homemade original potica.
Moko, kvas, mleko, sladkor, maslo, sol, limonino lupino, orehe, jajca.
Za testo je ponavadi kar en standardni recept. Za nadevi so pa različni. Imaš lahko lešnikovo, čokoladno, makovo, pehtranovo, rozinovo.
Ponovadi delamo druge pecive vmes. Lahko pa tudi za kakšno drugo priložnost, ne? Še če je kakšen tak večja priložnost, kakšna, ne vem, poroka, kakšna obletnica rojstva. Petnajst minut ali pa še malo več.
Prek Murija pa gor se mi zdi, da imajo bolj te okrogle. Zdaj pa bolj tako, vsaj kakor sem bila jaz seznanjena. Drugač pa zelo veliko se zdaj že okrogle dela. Moka? Mhm. Ko? Pa.
Ana, how does it feel?
It's nice. It's warm.
Pokrijemo s prtom, nasledno. In da izhaja, da mora biti. Polkna skleda. Orehe zdaj poparimo z mlekom. Nekateri jo znajo, tudi mladi ljudje znajo dobro potico narediti, ampak zaradi časovne stiske jo najraje kupijo. Kakšni jo pa tudi delajo, ker vidim, da imajo po internetu zelo veliko receptov noter, da se sprašuje, kako pa kaj. Mislim, da se bo prenašal to naprej še, ja.
Is it good?
Ja, very good.
In vse tako?
Mhm.
Ja?
Ja.
Vidimo, če dost.
Je. Ja, kako sem se matrala zvijati jo v modelček noter, ni mi šlo v tak model. Imela zmeram preveliko, ni šlo, pa sem kar malo potlačila. Ja, mi imamo tako navado doma, da se zmeram za božič. za Božič rojstni dan, dobimo pri mojih starših za Božič in Veliko noč. In se vsi otroci, starši, otroci, vnuki zberemo skupaj in če imaš dober želodec, jo lahko poješ takoj. Še topla je najboljša.
Ops. Na prvo.
Orehe. Lih promaš.
Ja, prav mi je delovalo, da jih bom malo mal. Sem porabila tist, kar je bilo v redu. Zdaj pa potico zvijamo. Moramo jo pa fajn na tesno.
I will cover it again and put to grow for next half an hour.
Da ni za polno. Tamo je na 180 stopin za 3/4 do 1 ure. Mal je počla, ampak bo jih tako dobra.
Now that we are done, it's time to let Jurij Galicic test the three potica.
I'm just gonna smell it first. By the shape and by the taste, I think I know which one it is. I think. It's not bad. I believe this one is homemade because it's in the shape. This one is really good. It's juicier. The filling is more rich. Not that this one was dry, but this one is, I think it is better. And this is the third one.
Yeah.
If I can guess, this one is from the industrial bakery. Mm-hmm. The middle one is homemade one, and this one is from Ljubljana.
Yeah.
How did I do?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. Wow, bravo,
yes.
Bravo.
Yeah.
Very good.
Thanks. I like potica. I usually also make it at home.
Mm-hmm.
But in Slovenia, it is very popular to do different fillings. So this is the most popular filling with walnuts.
Mm-hmm.
But at home, I like to do it with tarragon. But I like this one also. First time I made it actually was for Easter, and I made it walnut. I did it by the recipe of Mama Sonia from the house Jezeršek. She's probably one of the most famous bakers of potica in Slovenia, and her recipe is definitely, you cannot miss if you follow that recipe.
Okay.
The third one, was it a little one called Le Potica?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I recognized the shape, and I ate this couple of days ago in Frankfurt because Jezeršek brought it to the fair where Slovenia introduced to the general public, so yeah. I know that whenever we go and try to introduce Slovenia to the foreign people, we say this one is one of our genuine dishes. So if you want to taste Slovenia, you have to taste potica and kranjska klobasa, definitely. So potica and kranjska klobasa for me are most popular exports for Slovenia. Potica usually comes on the table when the whole family is gathered and everything is festive, everybody are in a good mood, feeling okay. Yeah, I connect these memories also with potica. Well, it's not the easiest dish to make, so you have to reserve a little time to make this, but I think the ones who want to cook Slovenian food learn how to make potica. I have two daughters. I'm gonna make sure they know how to do it. Not now, they are too young, but when they grow up a little, I'm gonna make sure they know how to make potica. This one was the best. Yeah. I never care about the look. I care about the taste, and the taste is definitely the best. I like to cook very much, and I like to taste. I'm that kind of cook that always tastes the food.
There are two teams. the ones who prefer homemade potica, which is tastier but takes hours to make, or the ones who prefer industrial potica, which is less tasty but saves them some time. And you, what team are you in?